Look at that. Look at the steam coming off of there. I don't know if you can hear that crunch. Oh, it's hot.
So Scotty Martin wanted some people to put up some recipes for the CFN recipe site. And I thought, why not? Caught some walleye last night, so let's do some bait to go. And instead of focusing on the fish, let's focus on a side. Like, what do you eat with the walleye? I always struggle with that. And I looked up a recipe recently, and it turned out really good, so I'm doing it again. It's zucchini fritters. And basically what you need to do, just take a zucchini. I like some of the skin, but not all the skin, just because of the flavor. So I always peel off portions of it when I'm doing something with zucchini. And then you just simply shred it. I've already shredded up some zucchini. You can put it in a strainer just to initially get the moisture out of it. And if you salt it, it also helps to bring some extra moisture out of it. You don't want it soggy. You're definitely going to want to dry it up before you do the fritters, or they won't crisp up real well. I like to add onion to mine. This wasn't in the recipe, but I definitely like onion and fried onion. Come on. So I'll put some onion in there as well. Because they're shredded zucchini, the size of the zucchini shreds is about the same as a half onion when you do that. So I kind of like that sizing because it matches up with the zucchini well. Goes off to the side because the zucchini needs to be strained a little more. And then bait to go. For this one, because it's going to be with the walleye, and my favorite on walleye is the crispy Cajun, we're going to go with a good dousing of the crispy Cajun. So, in here, flour, egg, bait to go, salt, pepper, garlic. And you can see my measurements are so exacting. That's about right. You can see I like garlic by the size that I buy. Alright, so that we're just mixing up. That's about the consistency that you want when it's kind of sticking. It's not sloppy, but it's not dry either. We're gonna take a cheesecloth and we're gonna put the zucchini, well, this isn't a cheesecloth, this is a J-cloth, but it suits the purpose. Okay, we're gonna put the zucchini into the cheesecloth. So, why do you do that? There's still so much moisture in the zucchini, especially when you put the salt on it, and it starts to seep. And you don't want wet zucchini going in there, it's going to make that batter too juicy. It's not going to fry up. You can see already the moisture that's in here. It's already coming out just by setting it on there. So we're just going to take that I didn't, that's not from washing it. That's not from adding any water. That's just the water that's in the zucchini. So if you twist the bag, and yeah, the J cloth came right out of the garage. It was just my, you know, brag for cleaning my boat, my truck. Oh, it was new. So you're gonna squeeze as much water out of the zucchini without popping the J cloth as you possibly can. And the zucchini is really easy to get out of the J cloth, where if you're doing it properly, the cheesecloth just comes out in a ball. So just kind of break it up and mix it around. So again, it's flour and egg and salt and pepper and bait to go and egg and garlic. And that's it. That looks about right. So there's your consistency. It's sticky, but not too sticky. It's moist, but that zucchini didn't really change the moistness of that much at all. Okay, if I move it, you can see the bottom. A nice olive oil. Olive oil heated on high heat in the pan, which we'll get going next, and then fritters into the pan. I'm gonna prepare some walleye first. So let me get that set up and then we'll come back. No negative comments on how I fillet them. Especially from Tyler. I know he'll have something to say. And these are little guys, so I'm not going to be getting wings and cheeks out of them. There's a little bit extra meat here and there that I'm getting. I didn't get anything right off the front, but there's a little bit more when I use that technique. Works for me anyways. Want to see where the camera is? All right, you're back in the dish tray. So walleye has been drying in the paper towel. So that should be pretty much ready to go. My breading is a mixture of Panko breadcrumbs, Kikkoman. Made-to-go outdoor flavors goes in with that breading. And of course that's crispy Cajun. I'd say almost half and half. I like a lot of flavor. And pepper. Lots and lots of pepper. So why the eggs? The egg is there to do an egg wash, and normally you would do an egg wash with flour and then the egg and then your breadcrumbs. But I have found that you can use the bait to go as your base layer instead of flour. So why make it more bland when you can punch it up with even more flavor? So the base is actually bait to go. Lastly, more Parmigiano Reggiano into the crispy layer. Pepper and Parmesan go so good together. It's gotta be fresh cracked though. Can't use that powdery black pepper. It's just not the same. I usually have one of my kids here helping me so I can keep one dry hand and one wet hand. Not so good at doing this without getting mucky fingers, but I'm gonna try. Try to just keep one wet hand. So we're just giving that a coating and I'm shaking off the excess. And then one at a time into the egg wash, just fully coated in egg. You don't need to soak it. Let the drips come off. Punch it in, push it on so it really cakes on there. If there's a little spot that doesn't have any, I press it in with my thumb. That's the final product there. There's lots of coating on there. They're coated up really well. The better layer of coating you can get to stick to these things, the crispier they come out, which is what I love. I love hearing about all the different frying methods that people use. I'm always surprised when people just take a piece of walleye or a piece of perch or a piece of whitefish, put it in the bait to go only, and then fry it up. I mean, I've had that, and it's good, but once you've done this once, I don't think you'll ever go back. Walleye is my favorite at all game fish. Well, freshwater game. For me, walleye, and then perch, and then crappie, and then whitefish. I do like trout and salmon as well, and I'm one of these rare fishermen that actually eats fish. I don't know what's up with that. Everybody I know and love that I fish with on a regular basis, except Chris, they fish nonstop. They don't eat fish. I think that's so funny. I'll bet you, if those friends of mine that don't eat fish ever had this, they never like bring themselves to eat it, they change their minds in a hurry. I've got one kid in this household, and I've got five kids, and the one kid in this household, Kaleo, will not eat fish. Has not eaten fish ever his entire life, except maybe a couple of times when he was just young, and just refuses to even try. And I tricked him into eating a piece of this before, and now he asks me to make it. Not all the time, but not only will he eat it, he actually likes it and asks for it. It's the crunch. It's white fish meat, and if you catch it fresh and you clean it right away and you cook it properly and you give it a crunch, the kids will eat it. And the key really is the crunch. They look like chicken fingers, right? So that's the thing, I guess. It looks like a chicken finger. Buy the wet hand and the dry hand. That's why. I just don't like getting both hands like that. All right, so they're done. We'll put them in the oil. And we'll get the fritters going in probably only 5 minutes. All we're going to need, then we'll be eating. Olive oil. In order to get good olive oil for not too bad of a price, Winners. They have like a little kitchen area at Winners. And man, they have some good quality stuff. And that's $10. And it seems like, you know, $10 is a lot of money for cooking oil. But this is a quality of oil that you can do focaccia bread with balsamic glaze. If you've never had that, you got to do that sometime. Balsamic glaze and olive oil with focaccia bread dipped. That's my movie snack. So instead of having popcorn, I'll make that up. And that olive oil is so good, you can literally drink it. It's $10. It's not bad. So one other thing that I do that, I don't know, maybe everybody does, maybe nobody does. To get a little extra brown on the breading, I actually do butter mixed with the olive oil. And I know it's not good for you, but look at the belly. It comes from somewhere. It comes from the butter. The butter browns up. And when you use butter, you'll get a better brown on the fish than you do with just oil alone. So while the oil's heating up, I'm just going to do up a little bit of a garnish. Italian parsley. My OCD nature requires me to pick off the stems. For me, the quickest and easiest way to get lettuce done or pop up a garnish, just squish it into a bowl. And then when you chop through it, keep it squished. Keep it all bunched together in very, very, very short order. You have some pretty fine parsley. I actually don't eat lemon with my fish like this, but the kids do, so this is more for them. So they like triangles. There we go, little garnish. Okay, let's test the fritter oil. Oh, it's looking good. That might actually be a touch too hot. So we're just spooning these out into like pancakes. That one's too big. Oh well, that'll be for me. Just like pancakes, you try not let them touch. For the walleye, we just load up the pan. I try and get it so that I can get it done in two batches. There it is. That looks good. Looks good. Okay, so we turn that down just a little bit. I'm gonna take it off the heat. Just let oil can cool down just a little bit before the next batch, but beautiful, eh? You gotta find that balance that you like of the how big you want them and the thickness of them. If you make them too thick, well, if you make them thicker, they're a little more squishy inside. Some people love that. If you make them thinner, then they're like crispy right through. Maybe you like it that way better. You play with it. You gotta do it like 3 or 4 times until you figure out exactly what you like. But for me, just a little bit of softness on the inside, a little bit of moisture on the inside is what I like the best. I did fish on this last, right? So there's fish on there. I don't just wash it. There's bacteria that can stick on there. I take the lemon and I rub the lemon on the board, and any fishy smell that was left on that board is gonna come off. Now, while the
fritters are cooking and the fish is cooking, I will let that sit in the lemon juice. And that's just like the last little bit of the husk, right?
All right, these guys are ready to roll. Just about the perfect roundness. I can actually probably turn that up just a ton. So instead of using a whole ton of vegetable oil, spending a little more on the olive oil imparts a little more flavor. And by putting butter in, you get this froth, which helps to brown around the upper edges of the fish. So you get a nice, even browning on the fish. These should be good to go. Yeah. That was, I don't know, 5 minutes. They don't take a long time to cook. A lot of people overcook their fish. I mean, 7 minutes might be overdoing it for me. So there's the color of the walleye when it's fried. And the crispiness is sensational. Just grab one piece here and break it open. Look at that. Look at the steam coming off of there. Oh, if you can hear that crunch. Oh, it's hot. Hey, look, it's my cat. Hi, kitty. That's Shadow. I put some coleslaw in just for some freshness because this is all fairly heavy and fried. Tomatoes. Salt and pepper tomatoes. Delicious. I gotta go get some company. Oh, speak of the devil. So this is Kaleo.
Here, here, here.
Okay, thank you.
There you go. Take a bite. So good.
It's a good little kick to it, too. It's very good.
See, the test here is whether he puts it back on the plate or actually finishes it.
I get more lemon, then I think I'll finish it.
Over the plate. There you go.
Thank you.
All right. The kid who don't eat fish. I knew he liked it. I knew it.